குப்பம்மாள், ரகுபதி யோகி, இசக்கி சுவாமி, ஆல் த்ரீ ஆஃப் தெம் ஆர் சிட்டிங். Talking some future plans about my future, and Isakki Swami has told one of his devotees, disciple, to give money for building the ashram for me, and the money was given to Kuppammal, and Kuppammal was telling Isakki Swami what all the work has happened and then the discussion was going on about building my future. And in those days in Thiruvannamalai, there was a Kalyana Mandapam called Meenakshi Kalyana Mandapam. It is in the street Kamakshiamman Koil Street, behind the Kamakshiamman Temple. In Thiruvannamalai, there is a street Kamakshiamman Koil Street. Behind that Kamakshiamman Temple, there was a Meenakshiamman Kalyana Mandapam. There was a meeting done by Vishwa Hindu Parishad. One of my father's classmate, and I think I can say that my father's friend, name is A.B.T. Shaktivel. He was the president of Vishwa Hindu Parishad, and in Thiruvannamalai Vishwa Hindu Parishad, Hindu Munnani, all of them a very close association. They are doing a wonderful job, and they will, in those days they used to conduct regularly this, even for Ayodhya Rama temple, the bricks they used to worship in every home. And I still remember I got one brick from A.B.T. Shaktivel and worshipped in my home for 11 days, singing Rama bhajan, Rama nama sangirtana, and then doing puja and taking it and handing it over. Few rupees in those days, some I think 80 or 90 rupee I could collect from all my family, friends and everyone, and collected and gave. Surely less than 100 rupee. Gave that donation also. Like this, lot of activities will happen. That day there was a meeting. Some people who are teaching about the Hinduism and how to be the Hindu activist, there was a meeting, and all three of my gurus insisted I go and participate in that meeting. I said, if you guys say, I will naturally go. And they took me to the meeting, and I could see the sincerity of my gurus, how constantly they will think for me, constantly they will work on molding me, chiseling me, carving me, building me. They insisted that I should go to Ramakrishna Mission and have training in Ramakrishna Mat. Kuppammal even tried reaching out to them, but Ramakrishna Mat said only after 18 they can admit, accept anyone. But I was not 18 at that time. But my gurus know that they are going to leave the body soon, so they gave sannyas and initiation, everything to me. But they gave me the instruction that I should go and spend some time in Ramakrishna Mission and learn. I said, how Ramakrishna Mission will not allow me anymore, because they don't accept the sannyasis who have taken sannyas from other sampradaya. only the brahmacharis who have not taken sannyas or who are not married, only they can join in Ramakrishna mission, and they have to be sannyasis in the Ramakrishna mission. Means the Ramakrishna mission will initiate and give sannyas. But my gurus, because they are going to leave the body, they already, at that time I did not know they are going to leave the body, but they gave all the sannyas initiation, all the proper rituals are done, everything is done. But they were insisting that I should go and learn from Ramakrishna mission. I said, how is it possible? Because they will not allow anybody who is a sannyasi from other sampradaya. Then my guru has contacted one of the sannyasi of Ramakrishna mission. They said, he gave a idea. See, he can come and be a volunteer here. Only after 10 years, the sannyas interview will happen. In that interview, if the Guruji decides, the Guru decides, he can even give sannyas again. If the Guruji decides he doesn't want to give, then he will be asked to leave. Or he can be a volunteer. He can continue to be a volunteer brahmachari. Volunteer sadhu, that will not be a problem. There will not be a problem in being a volunteer and learning. Anyhow, so it was decided that whether they will give sannyas to me or not, I will go and be a volunteer and learn. And I was very sure they will not give me sannyas, because I formally received, not only received sannyas, it is documented. And I did not hide from Ramakrishna mission. When I went, Ramakrishna mission swamis, they know that I already had a guru, and the guru has given me sannyas. And even I brought some of the Ramakrishna mission sadhus to Tiruvannamalai to show my guru's samadhi, and we have photographs of all of them visiting Isakki Swamigal samadhi. And this is my photograph in Ramakrishna Mutt as a brahmachari, and we have photographs of even Ramakrishna mission sadhus coming to Tiruvannamalai and visiting my guru's samadhi. Anyhow, my gurus continuously worked on me, chiseling me. They insisted I should go and learn from Ramakrishna mission, Bhagavan Swaminarayan's organization, the various internal sampradayas of Ramakrishna mission and Swaminarayan sampradaya. They insisted. Only now I know, because this whole Kailasa, the Moola Linga, the conscious blueprint of this Kailasa is from Ramakrishna mission. The conscious blueprint of this Kailasa, I want to clarify, Moola Linga is not a physical object. I don't want any stupid this Tamil Nadu publicity seekers going and giving a complaint, oh, Nityananda stolen Ramakrishna mission's Moola Linga. stop. When I say Moola Linga, I mean conscious blueprint. The conscious blueprint of Kailasa, like a Hindu knowledge, Hindu administration, Hindu management, Hindu publication, everything I learnt from Ramakrishna mission, I should tell you, I should put this on record. Forever, me and my Sangha is indebted to Ramakrishna mission. Every brick of Ramakrishna mission is built with integrity. The level of purity, integrity, commitment, authenticity. Ramakrishna Mission sadhus live is unimaginable.